Hello. Welcome back to Quake Clinic. I'm very glad to see you today. I understand we are working on a regular physical checkup. Great. Well, we have a little bit of paperwork to do, which might be a little boring, but hopefully, since I'm asking you questions about yourself, it won't be too boring for you. And then we will be able to get right into the exam. I will be asking you throughout the exam whether or not you have any questions for me. I know that a lot of the time when someone is performing an exam on you, it's difficult to remember everything that might be bothering you in your life day to day. You might forget that you've been having a lot of stomach aches, or that sometimes when you go outside you can't see as well at night, or the sun is too bright, or a multitude of things that could pop up as we go along. I want you to know that no matter what you say, I'm going to trust you and believe you and take you seriously on everything. So even if you don't remember until later on in the examination, feel free to still say what you need to say. Tell me everything. That's what I'm here for. Okay? So we're gonna start with our paperwork. I'm Dr. Elo. Can you please tell me your name? Okay. And what's your address currently? Is that Circle Avenue Street? Great. And what's your preferred method of contact? So we can do telephone call, text message, email. Okay, and can you give me that number? Okay, perfect. What about your birth date? Mine's right around there too. Cool. Let's also get your social security number. Do you know that? Great. Perfect. Are you employed? Okay. And what's your current marital status? Have you ever been married? Are you married currently? Great. Do you have an emergency contact person? Someone that, in the event that anything were to come up with a medication, or if you were to simply need someone to talk to during an appointment, or anything that might make you uncomfortable, do you have a person in mind? Okay. And what's their name? And then, do they have a telephone number that you know? Yeah, you can look it up if you need to. I know it's become less and less important to remember people's numbers. Okay, great. Okay, great, I've got that. Okay. And is there anyone else that you go see regularly? A doctor? Okay. Yeah, it could be a previous physician as well. Okay. And do you remember the last time you got a physical? Me neither, don't worry. Okay. Are there any recurring medical issues that you've had that you've dealt with? Okay. And do you take any prescription medications regularly? And what about over-the-counter? So, do you use any essential oils? Do you take Tylenol, ibuprofen, aspirin? And how often? Okay. So kind of as needed. Great. We've got one page down and into the system. How about any, this is sort of still off the counter, but what about any vitamins or supplements? Like if you work out or if you have any sort of deficiency? Okay. And have you ever had any allergic reactions to any medications or supplements? Do you know if anyone in your family has had any adverse reactions? Okay, and when was that? Okay. Are you allergic to anything else? Could be milk, pollen, dust. Do you know your current height and weight? I usually try to round up. I'm nearly 5'4". I'm like 5'3" of an inch, or yeah. But it doesn't matter as long as we're close. You can round down if you prefer to be short. Do you know what about is the least you've weighed in the past 5 years, and the most? Yeah, I know some people weigh themselves all the time. I weigh myself pretty compulsively, and other people maybe can just give me a range. So if you don't know exactly that you were, you know, a particular weight in June and another in October, and they differed by whatever, just I'm mainly trying to get an idea of whether or not your weight has severely fluctuated over the past 5 years or so. Okay, and that was pretty noticeable. Okay. How many hours do you usually sleep for at night, and has this changed recently? So, any sort of sleeping pattern changes, be they good or bad? Do you notice that you have particular trouble sleeping due to any sort of seasonal circumstances? For example, I know a lot of times around the holidays people become very stressed and might sleep more poorly, or maybe if it's dark out a lot in the winter, during a rainy season. Do you feel like your sleep is not as good as it is maybe when it's summer, sunny out? I know a lot of people Have you recently had any fevers or chills or night sweats? Okay. And do you regularly wear your seatbelt? I know that question seems to come off guard, but all of these things are sort of dealing with any potential issues you might have. I don't report these things to your insurance because I know that your insurance can change based on your answers, but it is important for us still to know what factors might be negatively influencing your health or things that could arise that might be problematic. We're here not only to treat what you might be feeling, but also to detect preemptively any problems that you might have in your future. And it's very easy while we're here for us to talk about anything and everything, so we figured we'd ask. Okay. Alright, and is that anything that you need to kind of talk about, or? Okay. Alrighty, so have you ever had any major illnesses or surgeries? Okay. And have you ever smoked cigarettes? Do you drink alcohol? Okay. What about coffee or tea, and if so, how often? Okay. And what are your hobbies like? Anything that you do for leisure? Yeah, it can be anything. You might take walks every once in a while, play video games, read magazines, anything that you don't do because you're being paid or because you have to, that you frequently revisit. Could be even taking a bubble bath. Okay, great. Very cool. Do you have any pets? Have you ever lived outside of United States? Have you or your family recently had any like life changes or major stresses, deaths in the family, anything that is contributing to a different family atmosphere than you usually might have? I'm really sorry. I know it's hard when you tell people these things and really all they can say is I'm sorry, and it doesn't change anything, but I do hope you know that I genuinely hate hearing about other people's suffering, and I really do mean it. I hope that things get better for you guys. I don't wish harm upon anyone, so. What's your current diet like? And please note that I have, you know, a hard time talking about diet and exercise to a lot of my patients, mainly because nobody likes to talk about diet and exercise. And here's how I feel about that. Look at the past 10 years. You know, there have been a multitude of diets, exercise crazes, fads, trends to deal with health that have been circulating around, and many of them have become bunk after a while. So they start off saying, you have to eat, you know, this much of this thing every Wednesday. And so you do it, and then 3 years later they say, actually, not that good for you. In my opinion, the most important thing is balance. And I know that it's very, very difficult for people to achieve that balance. And even if someone is physically looking very trim, the odds are that they are imbalanced somewhere else in their life. So, no matter what size you are, whether you don't eat enough, you feel like you ate too much, you feel like you're right in the middle, it really does not matter to me. I'm looking for your honest answers because I want to give you the highest quality of care that I possibly can. Don't be embarrassed. Don't feel like I think that there's a right way and a wrong way to handle these kinds of things, because I don't. I genuinely don't believe that. I think everything can be eaten and drank for that matter in moderation and with some balance. And if you ever feel like you want help achieving that balance, we can absolutely refer you to a dietitian or to exercise, basically someone who has gone to school. They're like scientists of exercise, so they can help you understand how the body works in that regard. We do have resources. Does all of that sound pretty fair? Do you feel comfortable talking to me honestly about your diet and exercise habits? Good. Okay, so let's get into it. You just tell me everything. I'm gonna take some notes, and I'm not gonna pester you for more information. Just share with me what you feel comfortable sharing. And I do need to know, though, whether or not you regularly eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Maybe you have a fourth meal in there somewhere, and that's okay too. Just let me know roughly how many meals you eat on the average day. I know that there are fluctuations. Sometimes I don't eat a meal. And okay, let's go ahead. I love those two. Okay. And that's about average. Okay, perfect. We've got that. And we've already discussed allergies, but as I mentioned in the beginning, sometimes information comes and goes from our brains. Did you have any food allergies that you might not have mentioned earlier? Okay, perfect. So we're another sheet down. We're gonna do a symptom review now. And for this one, I'm gonna move the keyboard aside a little bit here, and in that space, I'm going to physically mark this on your chart. Because of the way that we have our system set up. Okay, so please tell me, do you suffer from any of the following things? Feeling hot or cold all the time? Thyroid problems? Diabetes, excessive thirst, so maybe you are constantly feeling like your throat is dry, so you're drinking a lot, or you just genuinely feel thirsty a lot of the time. Okay, what about hyperthyroidism? And Cushing's syndrome? Have you ever had a hard time when being treated with steroids? Something like prednisone, something maybe to help your lungs, if you were having an infection or...
Okay.
Do you suffer from any sort of intestinal issues? So that was all for endocrinology. Now let's look at the dermatological aspects of your skin. Do you suffer from skin trouble with rashes? What about becoming very flushed in the face or elsewhere? Have you noticed any change in your hair or nails, maybe in the color, scent of your hair, the rate that either of them grow? Okay, I'm gonna move on to your head. Do you suffer from headaches? Migraines? Eye or vision? Have you ever had LASIK or any other corrective eye surgery? Any surgeries of your eyes whatsoever? Do you suffer from any nose congestion, sinus trouble, pressure in these areas? Okay. Do you have ear or hearing problems that you know of? Yeah, not when you don't want to hear something, but... Okay. Let's see, who else can I place here?
There we are.
How about any dental or tooth problems? I think everyone has some cavities every now and then. Actually, certain genetics can affect your teeth, and depending on your genetics, you might be more or less prone to cavities, so it doesn't always necessarily mean that the person with more cavities doesn't brush their teeth as much or has any lesser oral care than the person with less cavities. It's just, sometimes it's genetic. Okay. Do you have any false teeth? Have you had any implants or anything? What about any problem with your gums? Do you ever have any random gum bleeding? Yeah, I know sometimes you can brush or floss a little too hard, and gingivitis though, anything? Discoloration?
Okay.
TMJ. Yeah, this is when there's a little soft spot here, right near your ears on both sides where the jaw connects, okay, to the rest of your bone structure. And sometimes that's just a little off, and it can create, I actually do have TMJ, it can create a little clicking noise when you open your jaw. And it might cause some troubles with chewing, or you might get some pressure in here, some pain, especially when you're stressed. Have you noticed any symptoms like that? Okay. What about a sore throat? Do you frequently suffer from sore throats? Okay, and how about, do you ever get post-nasal drip, where you might get a sore throat because of it actually, but you feel like maybe something in the back of your throat is very uncomfortable? Okay. And do you ever feel like you have swollen lymph nodes, or have you have any history of having frequently swollen lymph nodes? This is this area right here. You can sort of feel. Yeah, yours actually feel fine right now. We are making our way through here. I'm gonna use the word breast, but this is for men and women. Do you ever have you check. Yeah, it's actually pretty simple to check. What you can do is raise your arm over your head and use your opposing hand to touch like this around the area. And if you feel any sort of knot or bump, you should probably call your doctor and have that checked out. So in this case, you might call me. You might call a specialist. It just depends on the severity of the issue and whether or not you feel confident that that is something that shouldn't be there. And the way, obviously, to check if it should or shouldn't be there is to do the other side and see if you have a similar feeling. So if you do feel something initially on one side, don't panic. Check if it's on the other side first. Yeah. Okay. We're going to move on to the respiratory system, your lungs. Do you suffer from coughing? Do you have a cough right now? It periodically counts. Okay. What about wheezing or any shortness of breath? And not so much after exerting yourself. This is more resting, shortness of breath. Okay, do you know if you snore? Okay. And do you have tuberculosis or pneumonia, or have you ever had TB or pneumonia? Okay. We're moving on to the cardiovascular section. Do you have any chest pain or tightness currently? What about palpitations? Do you ever feel your heart kind of skip a beat, maybe kind of clunks a little bit in your chest? We can look into that. I'm gonna listen to your heart and lungs here in a little bit, so. Yeah. Okay. What about your legs and feet? Have they been swollen? How about any high blood pressure that you know of? Okay. Heart attack, angina. Let's see. Have you had any blood clot issues? And do you have any varicose veins that you know of? These are usually on the legs. Okay, I know this is a lot. Do you have any questions at the moment? Okay. I'm the one with all the questions, I suppose. We're gonna move on to the abdominal area, digestion. Do you have any abdominal pain now or regularly? What about nausea or vomiting? What about bloating, gas, or indigestion? Heartburn, ulcers? Okay. Do you have any difficulty swallowing? Okay. And have you had any change recently in your bowel habits? Maybe going more or less frequently than you used to, or having trouble. Okay. Have you had any hemorrhoids? Okay. Okay. Have you had any urinary problems? Yeah, maybe pain, or you haven't been able to urinate as much, or you've been going very often. Okay, do you suffer from kidney stones? Urinary infections? Do you use a contraceptive method when engaging in any sexual activities? Moving on to the musculoskeletal section, do you have joints? joint or muscle pains or stiffness so that they limit your mobility in any way. What about swelling of the joints? How about back pain? Yes, I know a lot of people suffer from back pain and don't really get much done about it. I actually know an excellent chiropractor. If you're interested, I can refer you to. Okay. Do you have any pins or screws, implants from accidents or anything? Okay. Do you know if you have osteoporosis? Neurologically speaking, do you have any numbness or muscle weakness? Do you ever have temporary loss of your vision? What about your speech and your general strength? Okay. Do you ever have loss of consciousness? Do you black out ever? Not when drinking? And what about dizziness or lightheadedness? And do you notice that that is associated with any sort of stress or anxiety? Okay. What about any impaired memory or more confusion than usual? And if so, does it correspond with any changes in medications or anything that you can think of? Okay. Have you ever had a stroke? What about difficulty concentrating? Is that something that affects you? And when that happens, do you have any methods to work with it? Right. Okay. Right. Have you ever suffered from panic attacks, or do you currently? Yeah, those are the worst in my opinion. What about epilepsy or seizures? Okay. Doing great. Thing that I'd like to ask you about is going to be immunizations. I know that I personally rarely remember my own immunizations, so if you don't know the answer to these, that's fine. We can always check with any previous doctors you may have had and try to get those files. You'll just have to give us the name, which we already sort of talked about, and then we can contact them with your consent, and you really won't have to do anything about it. I'm just going to list off to you the immunizations that we're concerned about, and if you can remember having any of them, just say yes, or that one, or something. Okay. Pneumonia. TB. Tetanus. Hepatitis. Flu shot. Measles or mumps, sometimes also called rubella, and hepatitis B. Okay. Have you ever tested positive for chickenpox, tuberculosis, and hepatitis? Okay, great. I know that was a lot. So let's get started with our physical examination itself, now that we have all of that out of the way. Are you feeling okay today? It is actually a little warm in here, so don't be nervous. I can overwhelmed. But don't worry, it is a little warm in here. Okay. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is check your heart and lungs, if that's okay with you. I am going to have to be coming quite close to you. I am going to touch you, but I'm not going to touch you inappropriately whatsoever. I'm not going to come close to any regions that might make you uncomfortable. Unless you're uncomfortable with me touching your abdominal region, I will need to prod around a little bit and see if I can feel anything unusual. Is that okay with you? Okay. So here we go. I'm going to put my stethoscope on your wrist just here. And I'm going to listen and also take your pulse at the same time. So if you could just give me your arm. I'm going to warm this up too. Is that okay? I'm going to place it against my palm like this for a moment. Get it nice and warm. Okay, I'll take your arm now. And I'm just going to look off into the distance to read the clock while I'm taking your pulse. Sounds great. You've got a nice strong pulse going on. I didn't hear any murmur, palpitation, any sort of arrhythmia that worries me. Those might be indications towards heart disease, but I'm not hearing those. The next thing I'm going to do is check your lungs. So the first thing I'm going to do is place the stethoscope on the upper part of your chest. Then I'm going to move into your belly and place it there a couple times. Then we're going to move to the back. I'm going to put the stethoscope around you, and I'm going to listen first on your upper back near your shoulder blades, and then I'm going to listen at the bottom, sort of near your hips almost. Okay, ready? Down into your abdominal region now. Okay. This is okay. Okay, great. Alright, now I'm just gonna reach around you with the stethoscope. Back here near your shoulder blade. Okay, and just to make it easier, I'm going to stay on this side and go to your lower back. Can you please take a deep breath, nice and slow? I'll do it with you. In through your nose, and then we're going to hold for a few beats, and then we're going to go out of your mouth, okay? So here we go. Hold. And release. Great. We're going to do that one more time now. Okay, ready? Here we go. Hold. Exhale. Great, that sounds great. Let's come around to your other side now, and at the top, I'm just going to listen for a second, you don't have to do anything. Okay, and now to the bottom, and here we go. Hold. Sounds absolutely fantastic. Okay, so we've got that out of the way. Okay, now I'm going to just get a little check over your face, your skin. I'm gonna look for any sort of moles or skin tags or anything. Have you noticed anything at all? Okay. Yeah, so I'm just gonna touch a little bit around your scalp and the back of your neck, the front of your neck, and I'm gonna look at your face, as I mentioned. If you'd like to get a full body check, I have a dermatologist who is also so nice and does a fantastic job, but we don't do the gown situation here since this is just a physical checkup, and that being the case, I'm not in a position to examine your full body, so I'm just gonna kind of do from the neck up. Smooth, beautiful skin. Okay, check around your neck. Sorry, I'm bumping you a little bit. Check right under your chin. Okay, and your ear. The base of your neck. That feels good. Okay. Okay, I don't feel anything strange, any bumps or really concerning moles or anything like that. So I'm gonna give that a go. And next I'm just gonna take a little peek into your ears here. My flashlight. I'm gonna use mainly just my eyes for this check. Actually, completely just my eyes for this check. I'm not gonna bring out the otoscope at the moment because, as far as I remember, the school systems are only interested in making sure visually that you don't have any signs of anything that might be contagious or uncurable or something that might in the way of the population of the school. That's their main concern as far as I'm aware, so it might be a little selfish, but again, we can always do a more thorough check at a later point in time if you do have any concerns about your ears or your health. Okay, so let me take a look here. Of lesions or any extra marks on your skin that shouldn't be there. I'm just gonna tug a little bit on your ear a little bit. Okay. And I'm gonna come around to the other side. Now look here. Okay. Yeah, that looks equal. Ears are another thing, like eyebrows and the face, that they're just not perfectly symmetrical, but ears look symmetrical to a norm, so to speak. So I'm not concerned. I'm going to go ahead now and check out your eyes since we're here. I'm gonna look at your pupils. This light I'm gonna shine into your eyes. It shouldn't be too alarming. I'm actually gonna shut off this light behind. behind us just for a moment so that the only light that we will be working with is coming from the flashlight. I know that light isn't spectacularly bright, but this way will just be more accurate. Okay. Great. And now I'm just gonna pull up a little bit on your eyelid. On the other side. Okay, great. And I'm going to do the same thing for the bottom. Just going to drop your lid. Check that tear duct. And on the other side here. Okay, great. Now I'm going to do another pupil dilation test. And this one, I'm going to hold my hand up to the middle of your face, and what I'm going to do is first I'm going to shine the flashlight into one of your eyes, and I'm going to check that that pupil that's having the direct light is responding appropriately, and then I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to shine the light into the same eye, and the hope is that your other pupil will also dilate. It's going to respond to the light, maybe not as much, but enough, and this will be consensual versus direct dilation. Okay, so let me put this up here, and I'll come in and check this side. Okay, now I'm going to shine the flashlight and check the other side. Now we're going to do the same thing, other side. So, we're going to come in here and check. And now I'm going to shine the flashlight in the same eye, but I'm going to check your other eye. Great, that looks fantastic. Feeling. Yeah. Just take some time. You can close your eyes for a moment. Do you mind while you have your eyes closed if I just feel around a little bit around your bone structure here and your sinuses? Okay, thanks. Just keep those eyes closed. Open up if you'd like. Okay. Does that feel a little bit better? Great. The next thing I'm going to do for you here, I have some markers, and the caps to these markers are different colors. And I'm just going to hold a marker up for you, and if you could tell me what color you see, you can or you don't have to be precise as you'd like. For example, if you see purple, you can say lavender or purple. These are sort of pastel colors, which is why I'm saying that. But if you just want to use primary, not primary colors, but the primary name of the color, such as blue, green, red, yellow, etc., you can do that. If you want to get fancy and creative, this. Great. What color is this? Great. What color is this? This one? Correct. How about this one? Correct. And our last one? Great job. Purple is my favorite color. Okay. Now the last thing that I'm going to do is feel around a little bit. I'm just going to be checking for anything abnormal, so I'm going to start at the top of your head, pat my way down through your neck. I'm going to pat around your arms. I'm going to ask you to give me some resistance on your shoulders and your head. And then I'm just going to feel around in your abdominal region, as I mentioned I would do earlier. And we will nearly wrapping up at that point. Do you have any questions about the things that we've gone over so far? Yeah. Well, good. I'm glad that you feel comfortable to ask, so if you do think of anything, so here we go. I'm going to start at the top of your head here. Pat my way around. Yeah, very pretty eyes, by the way. Feel around the back. And come in and feel around your neck. Down your neck. Around the base of your scalp. I'm going to hold your shoulders here, and can you just push up for me? Great job. I'm going to hold around your head now, and can you tilt to one side for me? And push to the other side. Perfect. I feel down your arms now. And your hands. I'm just going to look at your nails. Same on the other side. And I'm gonna look at your nails. Yeah, I'm just sort of feeling them for firmness and healthy growth. Okay, now I'm just gonna feel down your sides here and into your abdomen, okay? I know you're a bit taller than I am on the examination table. So here we go. Feel around into your back a little bit. And I'm just going to hold one hand on your back, and with the other hand, I'm just going to press and swirl a bit into your abdomen. Please let me know if any of this hurts, especially in this area. I'm going to take my thumbs and press upward a little bit from the base. Does that hurt? What about here? And here? No. Okay, great. Well, it looks like we've covered everything that we needed to cover today. I don't see any reason why you can't pass your physical for school, so I am going to sign off on that. I do recommend, of course, that you continue to get the rest of your body thoroughly checked out, especially based on some of the concerns we talked about when we were doing your patient intake. Yeah. course, there are two tests I can do for that if you feel like you're having those symptoms. Yeah, so one of them is going to be a smell test, and the other one is going to be a hearing test, and these are basic preliminary tests, but I can do those now with you, and based on how those go, we can decide if you should go for further. Right, exactly. Okay, well first, let me... here, three different jars, and they're three different colors. I'm going to ask you to please smell what's in the jar, and then if you could tell me the color of the jar. Yes. Okay, please smell this. What do you smell? Okay, and what color is this? Purple, good. Number two, please smell this. Okay, and what color is this? Smell? What do you smell? Okay, and what color is this? Pink, good. Now I'm gonna make the same noise on both sides of your ears, and you let me know if you can hear it, then when you can stop hearing it. Okay? I'm gonna look into your eyes one more time. Yeah, let's just see here. And just keep staring straight at my face here. Okay, well, yeah, based on those symptoms and, yeah, I think that it might be a good idea to get a little bit of a follow-up on that. Yeah, before you leave, I will tell the receptionist to give you a card with that doctor's name and number on it. Okay, great. Hey, Tol, did you have any other questions or concerns you wanted to voice? Sure. And as you know, here at Quake, all of our doctors are also patients. We're all dealing with something, and that's part of what makes us different than other clinics. We really care about the level of service that we're giving to you, so if you need anything, you can call your case manager, and you can also call me directly if you'd like to. I know you have my number, but if I'm not available, if I'm in with a patient, you can definitely talk.